Hold up. So your family and friends have been pushing you to go into music, Abby. They've been telling you to start recording your own songs and been trying to motivate you to want to be like Wizkid, Burna Boy, Davido and the rest. So the question is, do you really have what it takes to go into this music business? Are you sure you are ready for it? This is Entertainment Business with James Silas, and today I will share some of the things you need to know before going into music. So the first on my list is why? Why do you want to go into music? Is it for the fame? Is it for the money? Is it for the women? Or you're genuinely talented? It's very important that you understand why you want to go into music, but this why is going to propel you to as to how you can actually achieve your goal. The truth is, some people are already in the choir, some people are already singing in groups in school, and then they know, or there's that conviction that they're actually ready to now take on the world. Making music, or it's just like any other business, there will be challenges. But every time you go back to your drawing board and understand and look at why you're on this race or in this journey in the first place, you see that it will give you that whole motivation and inspiration to carry on. So understand your why. It will propel you as to how to achieve that purpose. Second on my list is you need to know who you are, aka your identity. Now if I say Iblis, what comes to mind? Igbo boy, right? Oga boss. Iblis has an identity that he represents. The same thing with Fino or Flavor. Flavor is an African man, he's the Polopoto guy. In fact, when you call Flavor, in fact, sometimes people will say Flavor is an Ashawo. If I say Fouls, funny, witty, comical rap, right? Of course, it still makes serious music, but a lot of times when Fouls is on stage, you're waiting for him to do something funny because that's one of the things that we know him for. Nice, traditional guy, you know, Alako Miji, the Omo Ojo, and all the accolades that he gives himself, it just still comes to mind. If you hear Wizkid, everybody goes Starboy, and they start calling all the other, you know, acronyms that goes with him as an artist. The same thing applies to a lot of people. I mean, if you say Burna Boy, these days everybody will go African Giant, Odogwu, and so on. If I say Budge, it goes with Ote, you know, and you know the people that still flow around that circle. Ajebota, those people just think Ote. There's also Lagbaja. When I say Lagbaja, what comes to mind? The masked guy. Even as masked and faceless as Lagbaja is, that same whole facelessness is what makes him or gives him his identity. So you need to actually know yourself, you need to identify yourself and how you want people to see you, or how what should come to mind when they call your name. Now in the same line of identity, you need to have a unique name. You need to know, what are you going to call yourself as an artist? Do you want to be Akara Olobe? Do you want to be Bangolo and Granite? Alright, you can't just wake up one morning and say my name is Jet Fly, and they ask you tomorrow what does Jet Fly mean, and you're looking at them. And then back in the days, we had some people who go back to now come and start explaining J is for genius. J for genius. So it's important that you know what name you want to call yourself. If you want to use your real name, it's allowed. So but if you want to use some form of like a nickname or a moniker, identify, be, you know, very strategic, be deliberate about it. You know why you want to call yourself a certain name. So before you pick a name for yourself, it's very important that you do your research. When Notorious B.I.G. was calling himself Biggie Smalls, behold, even after he had started selling a lot of records, somebody came out from somewhere and said, yo, stop using that name Biggie Smalls, or else I'm going to sue you. And of course, when they did their research and all of that, they realized that truly, that guy was Biggie Smalls, so he couldn't use that name anymore. So he dropped Biggie Smalls. I mean, some people kept calling him Biggie Smalls, but it was no longer official for him to be Biggie Smalls. So if you want to do an acronym thing with your real name, or come up with something creative, that's all well and good, but you can't use a name that somebody else has used already, or somebody else. So it doesn't only apply in Nigeria or Africa, it also applies all around the world. You must have a unique name. That is also part of your identity. Next on my list is that you need to know your direction, and direction vis-a-vis style. Know the style that you're going to be, the style of music that you'll be known for. This also connects you to that same identity I was talking about the last time. Knowing your music, or knowing your direction, or knowing the direction of your sound and the music, that type of music that you really want to make, is very important for you. Because if you're going to be a rapper, let everyone know that, yes, so number one, you're a rapper. Okay, there's also the aspect of you being a pidgin rapper. There's one of you being an Igbo rapper or Yoruba rapper or any other dialect at that. it's very important that you know what direction of sound or what direction of music that you really want to, you know, go for. Now, we've had examples of a few artists who can actually diversify, who can, I mean, we have MI can sing, but if you hear MI singing all through an album, it will be awkward because we know him as African rapper number one, you know. So yes, you have those times where you can showcase your versatility, your other skill or talent, even in the music itself, but it's very important that we know what direction of music that you make. If you're a high life artist, focus on your high life. All right, yes, you can diversify, like I said, you can mix it with any other thing that you can do, but once we call your name and say Flavor, everybody knows it's high life. If we say Olamide, everybody knows he makes rap music and he also does street vibes. So understand your direction and follow it properly, because if you don't do that, you're going to confuse people. The next on my list is work ethic. Work ethic is very important, not just in music, in your daily life. People, if you're a banker, you work in the oil sector, you work with the government, work ethic is very, very important. I mean, what are we talking about here? Some people think that music is just for pleasure because you watch them on TV and see everybody laughing and everything. But they tell you the real backstory of what they go through. You understand that some of these artists used to sleep in the studio. Ask questions. I mean, watch interviews. Wizkid was a studio rat for a very long time. He was always going to the studio to go and wait for somebody to leave or whatever time is left for him to record. So it's a lot of work. It's hard work. You write your stories. You write your songs. You record. You go for video shoots. You do all of these things, and all of these things, they also cost money. So if you don't meet up, if you're not disciplined, you see that you keep wasting money and you keep having problems with even people that you work with. One day you might have an opportunity that's going to change your career or take you to the next level. But if you're not disciplined, if you don't take your time seriously, if you don't take appointments seriously, you're going to miss those opportunities. And trust me, words fly. People are going to keep telling each other that, that one is not serious, that one. So you have to be disciplined, you have to be professional. At the end of the day, you see that you change your career or take you to the next level. Next on my list is you need to mirror to create a roadmap. Let me explain. Now, I'm sure you have heard some successful people or maybe motivational speakers. They'll say, if you're in a line of business, you should look up to people who have become successful in that line. Even on Instagram, they'll tell you if you want to change the face of your page, you should choose somebody who has a similar or something or an aesthetic that you admire, that you like, and then fashion your own page to be like that person's one. All right. Now, we're not saying copy an artist. Now, we've had situations where some artists have mixed up their identity with the bigger ones, and the truth is fans did not really accept it, even as talented as those other ones were. I really don't want to make, you know, direct references, but I'm sure you understand what I'm saying. You need to pick somebody who you aspire to be like. You need to pick a bigger artist who has become successful in this line, especially in that field of sound that you make. There's no unique sound in the way that we say it sometimes. The truth is, if you make pop music, we have a lot of artists that make pop music. I mean, that's why awards, we have up to 5 artists who are under a certain category, all right? But what I'm saying is, identify who you like to be like. Identify somebody who has become successful in this business, and then fashion your work ethic to be like that person, all right? So if Tubaba says he spends 6 hours, 8 hours in the studio, if Burna Boy is always in the studio from morning till night, and you want to be like Davido, you must work as hard, probably twice as hard as these people. So that at the end of the day, you might not even become as successful as they are, but you will just be in line. Same thing applies in every other business. It might be in medicine, it might be engineering, it might be in any other business. Mirror your career, mirror your work ethic, mirror your aspiration, everything that you do to be like somebody, and then eventually that thing just going to work out, and perhaps you might be bigger or greater than that person at the end of the day. Next one, this is identify available resources. Now, identify available resources in this sense is you need to know the things that you have or the resources that you have at your beck and call. You might have a friend who's already in the music industry, who manages other artists, who is also willing to manage you or help you, even without paying him. You can also be a songwriter. You might have a friend who works at a radio station and all of that. I mean, there's also social media. Thankfully, you don't even need to pay to sign up for social media. Of course, you pay for data or you spend data to be on social media. However, that's a big platform that you just sign up and nobody's charging you for the time spent on social media. We've seen examples of people who blew just by showcasing their talents on social media. We have someone like Tunde Adenot who showcases a lot of young talent for free. And those people come there and then sometimes some of them are even signed, you know. We have a lot of them like that. I mean, what gets the point of money will actually go into nitty-gritty, but away from beyond money, say, come now, what exactly do you have as your own, okay? Before you say you want somebody to support you, you want somebody to help you, what have you done for yourself? Not about folding your arms and waiting for the best or the right opportunity when you have access to your even your WhatsApp. You can be rapping on your WhatsApp and you don't know who can be on WhatsApp that can identify and say, you come, what are you doing with yourself? And it will help you. Do you understand? So it's very important for you to identify your available resources, know them, take advantage of them, because those things can actually prepare you to the next level. In fact, even the good book says that your talent will make you die with kings. So what are you waiting for? Before you start complaining about money, what have you done for yourself? What are those things that are actually right there on the table that you, right under your nose, that you can take advantage of? Identify those things and take advantage of them, because they will change your story for good. Next my list is funding. When you hear funding, look, no long term. Money. Ego, goody, koko. Money is very important in this music business. If you don't have money, it can be a challenge. It can be, in fact, it can be very frustrating when you don't have the right funding or the funding at all to make this thing go to the next level. You need money to pay for studio time, you need money to pay for transportation to different places. In fact, you are going to have to pay some people, songwriters, to write for you. You are going to pay for music video. You need money for promotion, you need money for distribution. Money is very important. In fact, it's one of the most important parts of making music. But this is not to say that you should be discouraged even if you don't have money. It does not mean that you have my food down and say you don't have money. Like I said in my last in the last point, you need to first of all take advantage of your available resources before we now go over to the part where we're talking about money. Money is important, but don't make money make you lose focus. We have a lot of, let me not say a lot, but we have some of those artists, a few of them, who actually survived or who got to a certain level before money now started coming up, before someone now picked them up to support them financially. So don't be discouraged about money. I understand how this, in fact, a lot of talents are actually wasting because of no money. Now, I've seen some people sign some stupid deals because of money. They are so hungry, they are confused. And this, of course, some of them get to a point in their career, they're telling you that, when you are hungry, when you want something so bad, you sign anything. But music business is not cheap, but I need you to understand that money is important, and money in music can take you to the next level. The same way that same money can also destroy you. You still have to be financially responsible when it comes to funding your music project. Finally, you need to get your lawyer. Maybe some people tell you to have this as number one, get a lawyer, all right? It's okay to rearrange everything I've said here today and do them however you want, but all the keys or all the aspects I've mentioned are very important. I might even be missing out something, but you can tell me in the comment section. You need to get a lawyer. Remember I said take advantage of available resources. There's also the aspect of funding. Now, one of the available resources might be a lawyer. You might have a friend who you study together, and then maybe you went to school, you're also a lawyer, all right? It's very important that you have legal backing in this music business, because if you don't, we've had cases of, a lot of cases, I swear now, you might not have heard, but if you keep your ears to the ground, you hear a lot of artists, a lot of young artists, even the older ones that you see, have signed their lives away. Okay, maybe saying that they signed their lives away might be exaggerating it, but truth is, some artists, out of desperation, maybe not out of desperation, but out of the fact that they want to really, really do this music thing, have signed terrible deals that when they look back or when they look at it today, they will shake their head and know that, this mistake, and simply because they did not get themselves a lawyer. Now, you might not even have money. You might have zero cover in your account. You might have zero cover in your pocket, just your dream. Eh? But if you have access to a lawyer, I swear now, it will save you all the hassles that you ever face in your career. Now, some lawyers these days, and when I say lawyer, I mean entertainment lawyers. But truth is, if you even get any lawyer at all, first of all, who understand clauses and in simple English, they will save you a lot of stress, because there are some hidden things that some people put in their contracts that you will never ever know or never ever understand. You know, some people go as far as picking out contracts from America, Europe, and all those other countries, and then they'll come and give you here in Nigeria to come and sign. They want to sign it, and they say the case has to be judged in a New York court, and then you are here in Nigeria, and then when the time comes, the person, your liberal or guy will say, "Oh yeah, I'm waiting for you in New York." They're not going to buy your ticket, they're not going to buy your, give you visa or whatever. So you just shall be stuck, and you will not be able to record any, or put out any music or do anything with your career. And that's how bad it can get sometimes. So it's very important to have a lawyer. I know one of the things I always say is that it's better for you to have no money and have a lawyer than to have all the money in the world and no legal backing. It will be the biggest mistake you ever make in your life, because you can be successful at the end of the day, and tomorrow somebody somewhere will pull out a contract that you sign, and they will take all the penny you've ever suffered for, you know. So get yourself a lawyer. These days we have some lawyers who work with you on simple contracts, where even if you just started making money, but they will make it very clear. And then, I mean, a lot of lawyers are supposed to be professionals, so I don't see how a lawyer who is supposed to be saving you from contracts will now tie into a bad contract. I mean, that would be very unethical. So some lawyers are willing to help you, and they say, okay, for every time I service you, you're going to pay me 50,000 naira, and yes, you will know that you have been serviced, so that when you start making money, they are going to put out that same contract, and you are going to have to pay for the services. So I mean, that's even still fair enough. It will still save you the stress of paying millions at the end of the day. So get yourself a lawyer. It is, you see, it's a no-brainer. You must have a legal advisor when you want to do music. Remember, it's better for you to have no money and a lawyer than to have all the money in your pocket and no legal backing. This very statement, you need to thank me later for this, alright? So we come to the end of this edition of Entertainment Business with James Silas. Hope you picked and learned something. I hope you picked you got your pen and jotter to jot something. Yes. Follow my Instagram page at James Silas. My YouTube page is James Silas. I'm on Clubhouse, I'm on Twitter, I'm on Facebook. Follow all my social media accounts, and ask me any questions. If you have any questions, put them in the comment section. You can send me a DM, you can send me an email. My email is jamessilas2001@gmail.com. Holler at me. If you check my profile on Instagram, you see my phone number, you can send me a WhatsApp message, you can reach out to me. Ask me whatever you want to ask me. I mean, I'll do it for free, trust me. It depends. Thank you very much. I'll catch you on the next one. Yeah!